Washing with Michael Gaisnell, version 1.0. Today we're going to do a load of towels. So let's set the machine up. We're going to set our water temperature to hot. This machine is not equipped with automatic temperature control. So hot is true hot, warm is 50-50, cool might be 60-40, and true tap cold. We're going to set our options to heavy soil. We're going to select our deep till option that will give us a full tub of water. We are going to set our cycle selection from normal eco, which makes this the HE portion of the machine. We're going to set it to heavy duty, which makes this a energy wasting machine now. So let's open the lid, but first let's properly badge the machine. First up, the official title of this machine. This machine has been on duty since January 2nd, 2020. Since we're using the heavy duty cycle and not the HE cycle, we just threw away the high efficiency, which makes this an EH, efficient, hardly machine. This machine is also flux turgent, phosphates compatible. What the hell is that? That could be anything. It could be anything from your favorite laundry detergent. Could be any of your powder detergent. It could be bar soap. Or it could be something really awesome in laundry saw. JK18 approved. What makes this so special? It has phosphates. And phosphates matter in cleaning your clothes. This machine is also warm water rinse ready. More on that later. We prefer to have a full tub of water when we do our laundry. High water wash preferred. And lastly, and most importantly, this machine is JK18 approved. 5 stars. So let me gather my mentals and my chickens, and we'll be right back. So earlier I mentioned about how this machine is warm water rinse ready, and if you're mechanically inclined and not afraid to get into things, you can wire up your own switch to engage that during the rinse cycle. So for now, see the little red button here? It's the history eraser button. So I want you, the viewers, to very carefully watch over that button. So let's get started with the wash. First, we'll add our detergent. We'll start the machine. Add our towel. I have included the watt meter. Hope you can see it well enough in frame. We'll also add our fabric softener. Detergent is laundry saw. And the fabric softener is also from the same company of laundry saw, from the Snee company. This machine may seem loud to you. This machine is in a very small room, so there's going to be quite a bit of extra noise generated. This machine is still very new, so the tub indexing will be greater than a broken-in machine. This machine has excellent agitation. Got the classic tub lean. My favorite sport, right?
Oh, I can feel it. That's beautiful. You can feel the currents of water in there. I mean, any, you know, good washing machine that's not a shit design like they make today, any good washing machine that has an agitator like this will create these water currents that you can feel. And that pushes the water through the fabric, aided by the detergent you put in. That's what gets it clean. They had their shit together back in the day. They really did. But he's rolling. Old USA.
Looks like somebody touched the history eraser button. What Jay has to say about an energy wasting machine.
Killing the planet with those big incandescents.
And water wasting, top loading washing machines. And big fucking V8 American engines. Fucking right. We're gonna get global warming yet, you'll see.
ready for the warm rinse option. So with one valve on, the machine draws about 8 watts. With the warm rinse option on, it draws about 12.3 watts. Thank you. So there you have it. Another fine load of laundry done right. It's not just clean. It's Speed Queen clean. Always. So thank you for watching. Be sure to click like. Be sure to click subscribe. Take care. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye. And for a final closing, this machine, it has one job to do, which it did flawlessly. We'll pan over to the watt meter. Takes a couple of minutes for the machine itself to time out. If you choose to stick around and wait for it, fantastic.
0.0.
Double 0. That seems to be a little bit better than a Series 9 Speed Queen.
Just about 3 watts, and if you power it off...
Hit it again.
We go to that 0.2, and then it climbs back up to about half a watt. Mm-hmm.